Where is the research gap in your study?
Natanong ka na ba nung question na yan? Lagi na lang hinahanap, no, ang research gap. So, ka-schooler, ka-researcher, join me. Tutulungan kita na hanapin at makita ang research gap. Hello there! Welcome back to Ana PH. Yes, in today's content, we will talk about research gap. What it is, why do we need this, what are the types of research gap, and how do we find a research gap? All these questions will be answered in this video. So, keep on watching! A research gap is an area where missing or insufficient information prevents drawing conclusions on a particular question. For ETAR in 2002, a research gap is an unanswered question or unresolved problem in a field due to a lack of existing research. So again, ang research gap ay maaaring isang topic or area with missing or incomplete information. O kaya naman, isa siyang unresolved problem or unanswered question that prevents or hinders drawing conclusions. A research gap exists when there is lack of sufficient evidence or information on a topic. Also, it exists when there are already existing research but the findings of these studies are contradictory or are inconsistent, making it difficult to reach firm conclusions. For example, your research aim is to identify the most effective online learning strategy for students with learning disabilities. Upon systematic review of literature, you found small and large-scale studies on this topic. However, they are showing divergent and conflicting findings. Therefore, this is a research gap. So, based on our explanation and given examples, mahalaga ang pagtukoy sa research gap. In fact, according to Robinson and others in 2013, the identification of gap from the systematic review is essential to the practice of evidence-based research. O diba, kaya nga lagi siyang hinahanap ng research teacher mo. Kasi ang research gap ay mahalaga. So parang ikaw, mahalaga at importante ka. So ngayon na may clear understanding ka na kung ano ang research gap, ang next tanong naman natin, paano mahahanap ang true love? I mean, ang research gap. Here are the simple steps in finding for a research gap. 1. Identify the key issue, motive question, or your area of interest. 2. Review the literature covering your area of interest or key issue. And 3. Determine issues not addressed by the literature or what the articles are not saying. So ngayon, punta naman tayo sa 4 common types of research gaps. Knowledge gaps. These are areas where our understanding of a subject is incomplete, requiring more research to fill in missing details or expand on existing findings. Conceptual gaps. These involve a lack of clarity or development in theoretical frameworks and concepts, requiring further research to define or integrate theoretical models. Methodological gaps. These refer to limitations in current research methods, suggesting a need for new approaches or techniques to study specific questions effectively. Lastly, data gaps. These are deficiencies in the available data needed for research, indicating a need for new data collection efforts or improved measurement techniques. By the way, ka-researcher, in looking for those types of research gaps, you may focus on the following clues or particular parts of the research papers. So ayan, yung mga basic but the most important things you need to know about research gaps. So if you think this content is helpful, please hit the subscribe and like buttons. Pwedeng-pwede nyo ring i-share yung video na ito sa inyong mga classmates, friends, and fellow researchers. Especially if you guys have started working on your research project. Now, ka-schoolers, ka-researchers, before I end, I will give you a little assignment. So please enlighten me. If you have your prior knowledge on this, then you may use that. Or kung wala naman, you may use your research skill to find out or to search for the answer to my question. So my question is this: what is a perceived gap? What is a perceived gap? So kindly elucidate or discuss the concept of perceived gap. Okay, so yung may pinakamaganda at appropriate na sagot, makakatanggap ng Anna PH merchandise, o di ba? So please comment no your answers and I will read all of them. Okay? So there you have it, ka-schoolers, ka-researchers. Thank you for being with me until this part of this video. So stay tuned lang palagi ha dito sa ating channel. Better yet, you hit the notification bell para updated ka palagi unang-una kapag may bago tayong uploaded na video dito sa Anna PH. Once again, thank you and bye-bye!